I cannot look a resident in the eye and tell him that the government is not going to back the unions. Dismantling the strong and productive relationship between the unions and the government is a recipe for economic disaster. And friends, this just proves my point. The SDP tosses up proposals in a rushed fashion. Dismantle them, ask a few questions, they don't make sense. And it's fine to debate this during a rally. But if these proposals, if this is indeed the SDP's plan, major repercussions for all workers in my ward, all workers in Holland-Bukit, Timah, GRC. So look at the SDP's plan for what it really is, a rushed patchwork with dangerous consequences. Jobs credit was only part of the solution. That's where the government came in. But the union came in with spur to persuade, encourage the workers to go, get upgraded, and continue in employment. And also persuade the companies to keep the workers in employment. So it's a strong relationship between unions and government that keep the labor force with very low unemployment rate. Does SDP want to dismantle that? It seems so. And that's dangerous. Friends, politics is not about fancy theories, fancy footwork, 9 days of speeches. It is about lives. A few million lives. Service is about consistency and being trustworthy and reliable, especially in moments of crises. The last 5 years have not been easy. MPs have been on the front line. Our MPS cases have gone up. We try to look into the eyes of our residents and see the angst at the loss of a job in the family and try to place the resident with another job. Convince companies to continue employing Singaporeans, opening up the civil service jobs for those who have lost jobs in the private sector to make career switches and be committed to a cause, to the civil service. We were deliberately spending more time in the constituency, being with our people in times of distress. That was only 3 years ago. We saw our residents through the crisis. And it was no small crisis. The worst crisis we have seen as a nation since the time the Great Depression entered the world, years and years ago. So it's about being with people on the ground, week in, week out, day in, day out, being someone who can be trusted, being a reliable member of parliament, and being on the ground for the people. It's not about fancy speeches and populist calls. I would like to share one story with you which speaks of what we, in our heart of hearts, want to do and continue to do for the residents of Holland-Bukit Timah. I spoke of two examples at the Bukit Panjang site on Monday night. I want to give you a new and as meaningful an example of what we do almost every week. In Gimor, there is an old lady, an old auntie, whose daughter unfortunately got mixed up in the wrong company, took drugs, was convicted for drug consumption and sentenced to Changi Women's Prison for about 4 years. Her daughter had just given birth to a son who was about 2 years old at the time she had to enter Changi Women's Prison. The old auntie came to see us. We did a house-to-house visit. She came to see us and said, "Is there anything that you can help with?" I said, "Of course, auntie. How can we help?" So you see this boy, he's my grandson. He's now in my custody. I need to take care of him. I said, "We will support you as best as we can." We supported her, ensured that she had a job, gave her the vouchers that she needed to buy essentials, visited her at home. She came almost every month to give us an update on how her grandson was doing. Years later, her grandson went into Henry Park, the school of her choice, just down the road from Ghim Moh. He's doing very well. Before her daughter came out from prison, I wrote a letter to her daughter. I wrote saying, "We all make mistakes. So do I. But please know that there is a community waiting for you. There are people waiting for you. Your son is waiting for you, and so is your mother, to help you through this. And we will find you a job." And that was one of the first letters she received when she went back to her Ghim Moh flat. And we pulled out many stops and, in fact, got her a job offer just round the corner in Ghim Moh. She chose not to take it. She went into the waitress line. She's got a good and firm job now. That is what politics is about. It's about matching the macro policies that need to be debated in Parliament, push through crises, and help the people on the ground, because it's about Singaporeans. It's about our residents. And to the youth in the audience, I would like to say that the team who supported this auntie through was a team of young volunteers, committed to helping an elderly resident overcome difficulties. And now they are all very close to the grandson. So to the youth, as a youth, claim that horizon on the South China Sea. That's yours. Dream big. Grasp it. Hold it. Embrace it. Nurture it. And claim that horizon. Because the sun rises there for you, for me, for us. So join us in this vision of grasping our horizons, working together, and building a Singapore we can all call home. So I humbly submit to you, my friends and dear residents of Holland-Bukit Timah, politics is not about 9 days or 9 nights of speeches. It's about helping people. It's about overcoming adversity together. So choose the team, red, white, and blue. We'll see you through. Majulah Singapura! Majulah PAP! Undilah PAP!